It's day 217, and it's time to meet another one of my friends. So without further ado, please welcome to the screen writer, performer, director, and lover of squids. Yes, it's Sarah-Louise Young. You're wearing a halter neck.
I wore your favourite dress, $6.99, in a charity shop. You know, I bought it for a wedding, and the couple have since divorced.
But why am I laughing? That's terrible.
Much happier now, so are the kids. This was $6.99, and I literally, we worked together on every single show. I mean, I think that at one point you were going to stage an intervention and have it kidnapped.
Stop with the halter neck dress. And I'm wearing a matching, you see, I wore this shirt because you commented on a previous video with Mike Hind that this was, oh no, with Michael Ralston, that this was your favourite shirt so far. And I've run out of shirts to wear for, don't tell the audience, but I've run out of shirts. So I've started to couple them with a jacket now. This is also purple velvet.
You see, it's meant to be. Are you wearing pants?
I am wearing pants and jeans. Thank you very much for asking. Are you wearing pants, please?
I am wearing pants, yes.
Sarah-Louise,
I'm wearing pants that are so big that actually with this dress, I would never wear them on stage because of VPL. My lockdown concession. There you are.
VPL and TMI, all in one sentence. I've got three questions for you, Sarah-Louise Young. Are you ready for your first?
I am.
Oh, this is a big one for you. What is your recollection of our first meeting?
I have no recollection. I've had I'm not responsible for anything.
Who are you?
1873. We've known each other over 30 years, and it is entirely the fault of our very good friend, Sarah, who has known you since you were a baby.
Yeah.
And on meeting me at school, she thought, I know who you need to meet. You need to meet Paulus. I don't quite know why, but my life changed and I met you. In fact, we've been pen pals because we wrote to each other. You used to make me magazines called Breakages Punches, which was
Yes.
We made each other cassettes back in the day. Oh. I know. And but one, the first time I met you, I knocked on the door and I saw our friend Stuart and I thought he was you.
Oh,
so
yes.
I've known him about 2 minutes longer than you. And then I saw your hair and that was the rest.
And you are there, was hair. There was
it's
hair.
It's your fault, all of this. Or the glitter curtain, all of it is your fault. You played me Fascinating Aida on a record and Victoria Woods and then said, I'm going to bring variety to the West End. I didn't know I was coming with you. It's all your fault.
Did I really say that now? At like 13 years old? Did I say that?
Yeah. Your mission. You pushed all the Garfields off the desk and said, I'm going to bring variety to the West End.
God damn it. All right, second question. Sarah-Louise, how are you keeping creative at the moment?
It's so weird. I've had a nice time. Like, I wanted to sit down in a cup of tea. I was knackered. I feel like the first 3 weeks, I started doing things that were sort of creative, like my tax return and tidying the sewing cabinet. And then I realised that I was always doing creative stuff because it then needed to become a production at the end. So I thought I'm going to do something creative that's not about making money. I mean, because that's always the normal consideration. So I've been learning the ukulele. I've done some very creative cooking. I mean, it's tasted awful, but it's looked amazing. But I'm directing three shows virtually, and Michael Wilson and I carried on working on our musical, and we've been working on Looking for My Friend.
We have, yeah.
So it's felt creative, but it's just been a real change I miss people and I miss the interaction, and a few people have asked me to run workshops and I've said no because I'm really about being in the space with people. So it's changed the way I'm thinking about creativity. And my partner's a writer, so we do a lot of, you know, we watch stuff in the evening and call it work, you know.
It's so research, that is.
Yeah, it is research, and it's all tax deductible. Netflix is tax deductible, did you know that?
I try and get away with it because my husband, as I think you know, has got a degree in business, and he gets involved once a year when I have to do my tax returns and I have to justify these receipts. And very often there'll be something that says, what is this? £100 on drinks in the West End with Sarah-Louise Young. And I'll be like, oh, yeah, that's a business meeting. Yeah, business meeting. Yeah. Meals and entertainment for very much a business meeting.
But I've spent a fortune. I've spent a fortune on like this, you know, the poor children that had to hand sew this, probably in China.
Probably were.
I've done the odd gig. I've done some cabaret hall gigs, and I'm trying to. And I watched your wonderful YouTube thing on Zoom, and it's a whole new way of learning, isn't it? I mean, I own a ring light. What's become of me?
We are ring light wankers.
And look, I've literally been raiding the back catalogue.
Oh, it's the doll. Oh no. Oh no. That's from Cabaret Horror, isn't it?
It's terrifying. It's terrifying.
Listen, let's move on to question three before the doll takes over. what is it that you're looking forward to doing that you can't do at the moment?
Oh, I want to smell people. I want to smell an audience. I know that sounds weird, but I do. I really, smell's really important to me. And, you know, I haven't missed performing as much as I thought I would. Like, it's actually been nice to have a break and not to pull around the trundly suitcase around the country all the time.
Oh, God, yeah.
But I think there will be a magical moment when we get on stage and just that little realisation, probably for like 20 minutes, the audience will really appreciate it and not be on their mobile phone, and then it will go back to normal. I'm directing, you know, Russell Lucas, who I made my Kate Bush show with.
And yeah.
We swapped roles, so I'm now directing him, co-making the show about Bobby Kennedy. And he showed me just like a 15-minute performance, and I was in tears. Because it was another human being performing, and I was an audience, and that spun my brain. So of course I'm looking forward to that. I want to go to the pub. I want a pint of ale. I want to take my mum for a pint of Guinness. I'm not looking forward to doing exercise outside and not being able to cheat by moving off the camera so that my instructor can't see me.
My husband and I are currently doing yoga. Big up to the Yoga Edge, by the way, online. I'm paying for a monthly subscription, but my husband's doing it too, and we haven't told anybody. He's just off camera. But I just told them. Oh, right. Okay, so they know now. All right. Sorry, Yoga Edge. Listen, we're running out of time. Guys, don't forget to press the subscribe button if you'd like more like this. Now, sadly, Sarah Louise will not be with us tomorrow, but I will see you tomorrow.
If we're safe.
Oh, Sarah Louise, thank you so much for being with me. Lots of love, my darling. Take care.
Lots of love.
Bye-bye.